Good morning, and welcome to the historic Basilica Cathedral of St. John the Baptist. We welcome all of you present and those joining us through livestream. We ask that all during the ongoing pandemic continue to use hand sanitizers and maintain a distance of 2 meters. The wearing of masks is encouraged. Our gathering chant this morning can be found in your CBW number 531, For the Beauty of the Earth, and our presider this morning is Archbishop Peter Hunt. Please stand.
Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Today we celebrate the World Day of Prayer for the care of creation. It's a time for us especially to pray for our world and that we may treat it well. And I invite you to remember in your prayers today a little 2-year-old girl who's having brain surgery for a benign cyst today, Vivian Rose. If you could keep her in your prayers and her family as well. That we may worthily bring all of our prayers and petitions to our Heavenly Father, let us pause to call to mind His goodness and to ask forgiveness for our sins.
You were sent to heal the contrite of heart.
Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison.
You came to call sinners.
Christe eleison, Christe.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, that we may always revere and love your holy name, for you never deprive of your guidance those you set firm on the foundation of your love. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the first letter of Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, do not deceive yourselves. If you think that you are wise in this age, you should become fools so that you may become wise. For the wisdom of this world is foolishness with God. For it is written, He catches the wise in their craftiness. And again, the Lord knows the thoughts of the wise, that they are futile. So let no one boast about human leaders, for all things are yours, whether Paul or Apollos or Cephas, or the world or life or death, or the present or the future, all belong to you, and you belong to Christ, and Christ belongs to God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The response to the psalm, May the Lord come in, He is King of glory.
You. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Once, while Jesus was standing beside the Lake of Gennesaret, and the crowd was pressing in on him to hear the word of God, he saw two boats there at the shore of the lake. The fishermen had gone out of them and were washing their nets. He got into one of the boats, the one belonging to Simon, and asked him to put out a little way from the shore. Then Jesus sat down and taught the crowds from the boat. When he had finished speaking, he said to Simon, "Put out into the deep water and let down your nets for a catch." Simon answered, "Master, we have worked all night long and have caught nothing. Yet if you say so, I will let down the nets." When they had done this, they caught so many fish that their nets were beginning to break. So they signaled their partners in the other boat to come and help them. And they came and filled both boats so that they began to sink. But when Simon Peter saw it, he fell down at Jesus' knees, saying, "Go away from me, Lord, for I am a sinful man." For Peter and all who were with him were amazed at the catch of fish that they had taken. And so also were James and John, sons of Zebedee, who were partners with Simon. Then Jesus said to Simon, "Do not be afraid. From now on, you will be catching people." When they had brought their boats to shore, they left everything and followed him. The Gospel of the Lord. In our first reading today, Paul, speaking to the Corinthians, talks about how the wisdom of the world is foolishness with God. And today's gospel gives us many examples of that. The first one is that Simon Peter and John and James were professional fishermen. They had fished all night and were unable to catch anything. And this carpenter's son tells them to put out into the lake and they'll get a big catch. So it was foolishness in the ways of the world that they would even listen to his instructions. But they did. There was something about him, there was some authority in them that allowed them to overcome the wisdom of this world. And then when they catch this big catch of fish, Jesus asked them to leave their nets and to come follow him, to become fishers of men. And again, it's a foolishness both on the part of Jesus. Why would he choose these fishermen, men of little education, to be his followers? And foolishness on their part to leave something that they know and are good at to go and follow this preacher where there's no future at all. What we see here in the gospel is certainly the wisdom of God that baffles the wisdom of man, the foolishness of God that baffles the wisdom of men. So we continue in our Mass today. We ask the Lord to help us that we may be open to his foolishness, that we may not rely on our wisdom and the wisdom of the world, but that we may trust in him, and that we may seek always in all we do to be open to him and his guidance, even in the things that seem sometimes to us to be foolish. With confidence in God's goodness and recognizing our need of his assistance and his wisdom, let us stand and offer to him our prayers of petition. We pray for our Pope and for all of our religious and civil leaders, that they may always be open to God's guidance and that they may have the courage and wisdom they need to lead well. For this we pray to the Lord. We pray for ourselves and for all who have received the gift of faith, that having received this gift of faith, we may treasure it and be open to God's guidance in all that we do. For this we pray to the Lord. Pray for the sick and the suffering, for all those who are struggling with persecution or hurt or pain or grief of any kind, that in the midst of their difficulties and trials they may feel God's presence and his consolation. For this we pray to the Lord. We pray for those who have gone before us marked with the sign of faith, that they may have eternal rest with God in heaven. We pray to the Lord. Let us pause for a moment to bow our heads and offer our own personal intentions. For all of these intentions, we pray to the Lord. Heavenly Father, we ask you to hear the prayers that we offer you this morning, both those we have spoken aloud and those that are in our hearts. for they are offered through Christ our Lord.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness, we have this wine to offer for the divine work of human hands and become for us our spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever. Spirit, contrite heart, be accepted by you, Lord. May our sacrifice in your sight this day be pleasing to you, Lord God. Lord, wash away my iniquity and cleanse me from my sin.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Receive, O Lord, the sacrifice of conciliation and praise, and grant that, cleansed by its action, we may make offering of a heart pleasing to you through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father of mercies and faithful God. For you have given us Jesus Christ, your Son, as our Lord and Redeemer. He always showed compassion for children and for the poor, for the sick and for sinners, and he became a neighbor to the oppressed and the afflicted. By word and deed, he announced to the world that you are our Father and that you care for all your sons and daughters. And so with all the angels and saints, we exalt and bless your name and sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim.
And earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy and to be glorified, O God, who love the human race and who always walk with us in the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son, present in our midst when we are gathered by his love. And when, as once for the disciples, so now for us, he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father most merciful, we ask that you send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread and said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, gave you thanks, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which shall be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, Holy Father, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Savior, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again, and we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor on the oblation of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us. And grant that, by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. Bring your church, O Lord, to perfect faith and charity, together with Francis our Pope and me, your unworthy servant, with all the bishops, priests, and deacons, and the entire people you have made your own. Open our eyes to the needs of our brothers and sisters. Inspire in us words and actions to comfort those who labor and are burdened. Make us serve them truly after the example of Christ and at his command. And may your church stand as a living witness to truth and freedom, to peace and justice, that all people may be raised up to a new hope. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever. There, in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and martyrs, with St. John the Baptist, and with all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Through baptism we are God's children, and so with confidence we can pray, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin, and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of the Lord's peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Spiritual communion for those viewing online and for those who cannot receive Holy Communion at this time. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you, for you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. For the reception of Holy Communion, we ask that you begin from the side sections, maintain a 2-meter distance in the communion line, and sanitize your hands before receiving Holy Communion. Thank you. Our communion hymn can be found in your celebrating song 6.6, One Love Released. One bread, one body, one cup, one call, one faith, one spirit, present in us all, one prayer, one blessing, one hope, one peace, one church, one people. Spirit present in us all, one prayer, one blessing, one hope, one peace, one church, one people, one love released. Is not
share the body of our Lord. Is not this wine we drink the blood of Christ our poured? One bread, one body, one cup, one goal, one faith, one spirit, present in us all. One prayer, one blessing, one hope, one peace, one church, one people, one love released. I am the bread of life, eat and you shall live. To those who share this meal, my strength I'll always give. One bread, one body, one cup, one call, one faith, one spirit, present in us all. One prayer, one blessing,
let us pray. Renewed and nourished by the sacred body and precious blood of your Son, we ask of your mercy, O Lord, that what we celebrate with constant devotion may be our sure pledge of redemption through Christ our Lord. I invite you to join with me in praying the prayer of Pope Francis to Mary for help and protection during the coronavirus pandemic. O Mary, you always shine in our path as a sign of salvation and of hope. We entrust ourselves to you, health of the sick, who at the cross took part in Jesus' pain, keeping your faith firm. You, salvation of your people, know what we need, and we are sure you will provide, so that, as in Cana of Galilee, we may return to joy and feasting after this time of trial. Help us, Mother of Divine Love, to conform to the will of the Father, and to do as we are told by Jesus, who has taken upon himself our sufferings and carried our sorrows to lead us through the cross to the joy of the resurrection. Amen. Under your protection we seek refuge, Holy Mother of God. Do not disdain the entreaties of we who are in trial, but deliver us from every danger, O glorious and blessed Virgin. Amen. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your lives.
Thanks be to God. Our missioning hymn this morning can be found in your celebrating song, 6.39, The Summons.
Will you come and follow me if I but call your name? Will you go where you don't know and never be the same? Will you let my love be shown? Will you let my name be known? Will you let my life be grown in you and you in me? Will you leave yourself behind if I but call your name? Will you care for cruel and kind and never be the same? Will you risk the hostile stare should your life attract or scare? Will you let me answer